بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الصلاة والسلام على سيدنا ونبينا حبيب قلوبنا أبي القاسم المصطفى محمد وعلى أهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين. Brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. Congratulations on the arrival of the holy month of Ramadan. Alhamdulillah, we have the tawfiq and opportunity to experience another great month of Ramadan, which comes with full of blessings, rahmah and mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We thank Allah for this great opportunity that we have in front of us. And we ask Him to make this month the best month of Ramadan of our lives so far, inshallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Holy Quran, Surah Baqarah mentioned, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Shahru Ramadan, Alladhi unzala fihi al-Quran, Hudan lil-nasi wa bayyinatin min al-huda wal-furqan. The month of Ramadan is the month that Allah revealed Quran in this month. And Quran is the guidance for whole mankind. The one that with Quran, you can distinguish between haq and batil, between what is wrong and what is right. Now that we have this opportunity to have Ramadan in front of us, we have to be very smart to be able to take advantage of the moments of this month, inshallah. First, let me tell you about the etymology of the word Ramadan. Anything, any heat, burning heat, we call it Ramadan. Ramadan means the burning heat that burns the dhunub, the gunah, the sins. It's so powerful that destroys the gunah and sins and makes you pure and a better person, inshallah. Ramadan came with a lot of gifts. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us in order to take advantage of this month and to make the most out of it. He gave us a lot of opportunities and tools in this month. A lot of ways that we can take advantage of this month with its full potential. Number one tool that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us is fasting and ruza. The Sawm that alhamdulillah is mandatory in this month, one of the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. However, according to traditions and rivayat, khutbah sha'bani by Rasulullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, fasting is not only abstaining our stomach from eating and drinking. Brothers and sisters, Rasulullah says fasting means your whole body should be away from amma kariha Allah, from anything that Allah doesn't want you to do, from anything that is haram, from anything that is harmful to you. This is fasting, including your eyes. You have to close your eyes. Do not look at anything that is haram, specifically in this month and all the time. Your ears, do not listen to anything that is haram. Do not listen to them. Your hands, your hair, your anything in this world, your whole body part should abstain itself from anything that is haram. Specifically, your tongue. Be careful, specifically in this month, you should work on all these aspects. Someone was, you know, doing qaybah, talking bad about one of the family members, and Rasulullah says, bring food to her, and she would, you know, open her fast. She said, I'm fasting. Says, yeah, but what kind of fast it is that you're talking bad about someone else. So we have to be very smart, inshallah, and understand these opportunities and the threats that might take us away from the thawab of this month. What I'm going to say is that make sure, inshallah, you mu'mineen and mu'minat, be creative in this month. Make your fasting more creative, including the niyyah you have sincerely for the sake of Allah. Add into this by the amal, by better being better person in Ramadan, inshallah, and make your fasting better. The second tool, as we mentioned, is Quran. لِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ رَبِي. For everything there is a spring. رَبِيُّ الْقُرْآنِ شَهْرُ رَمَضَانِ. The spring of Quran is month of Ramadan, brothers and sisters. Make it more creative again. In this month, not only, inshallah, you will recite more Quran, at least one juz in whole every day, inshallah, but also add into the tafakkur as well. Think more about the ayat of Quran. Pay attention to translation. Pay attention to the tafsir if inshallah you have time, and get the most out of this Quran that is in front of us, inshallah, and take this opportunity and this tool in order to become better, inshallah. The other things is a'mal. of this month, the du'as in this month. MashaAllah, I was reviewing the mafatih and the books of du'a. You can't count how many a'mal and du'a we have in this month. In different categories, the a'mal of the days of Ramadan, the a'mals of the night in Ramadan, the a'mals of the suhoor and the time of fajr in Ramadan. My recommendation to all of us is that at least make sure you review this a'mal once. At least make sure in this Ramadan, go through the books of mafatih and other books that you might have to see what are there that you can do that you have never paid attention. So inshallah, adding to the tawfiqat that you have as well. This will help to take advantage of our time, that we don't just use Ramadan as other time, and we don't want this Ramadan to come and to go away from us. So we have to be smart, inshallah. The last things I want to mention is that the family bond that we have to pay attention. Your akhlaq and your behavior is very, very important. Rasulullah says one of the best things in Ramadan is husna khulq, to have a good temper in Ramadan. I know that sometimes we're fasting, we might get, you know, hungry, our temper might change, but we have to show to each other that Ramadan is the Eid, is the best month for us, that we change our amal, we change our behavior to be better, inshallah, with each other. And have the congregational ibadah together. You can have the ibadah, you know, congregational salah, jama'ah together. You can have recitation of dua together. You can have anything, iftar, mashallah, together, and make it more family bond in this month, inshallah. The jama'ah, that is very important. My last recommendation, Ramadan is like other months, the month of Ahlul Bayt, the month of Imam of Asr, Imam Mahdi alayhi salatu wassalam. He is the one who is in charge of the ziyafat of Allah, the ceremony of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, specifically in the month of Ramadan and night of Ghadr. Make sure you do tawassul to Ahlul Bayt. Make sure you read more, you do tawassul, you get closer to Ahlul Bayt, which they are the way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent his peace and blessings upon the mankind. Inshallah, through paying attention to Ahlul Bayt and getting closer to them, we will have the opportunity to be able to take the most out of this month, holy month of Ramadan. Once again, I congratulate all of you for the arrival of month of Ramadan. May Allah inshallah give us tawfiq and opportunity to be helpful to others and to be able to pray for everyone that are in need of our dua, inshallah. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.